Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So this is part 3 video of forensic entomology and this is the last video for it. In this video, I'll be discussing about the sample collection procedures, the equipments and tools required and the site of sampling. Also, how the samples are preserved. So let's start with the equipments and tools that are required for collection of samples at the crime scene. First is a fine paint brush is used for collecting the eggs. For collecting maggots, we use spoons. Then for collecting the adult and the more fragile immature insects, we are going to use fine and medium forceps. Then for flying insects, hand nets will be used. For storing the samples or the specimens, dead samples, we are going to use ethanol, which is having 70% alcohol concentration. Then the protocol sheets are used for writing down what specimen was collected in order to have a proper data. Then labels will be used to label the different specimens. Vials and storage boxes of different sizes are used for preserving living and dead insects separately. Sawdust or tissue paper is used for handling the eggs and living larvae in vials or storage boxes. Shovel and robust plastic bags are used for the soil samples, collection of soil samples and the leaf litter. Thermometer is used for measuring the body temperature and the ambient temperature as well as for the larval mass temperature. And camera is used for photographic evidence. So these are all the equipments that are used. Then the common sites of sampling is the natural orifices and eyes, traumatic wounds. Then we can look for the insects at the corpse substrate interference and also under the body. We can find them in the fold of the clothes, pockets, shoes, socks, all these areas has to be looked for. From the carpet, bag or material in which the body might have been wrapped. From the plastic body bag in which the corpse or the remains have been enclosed for transport to the place of autopsy and storage. So these are all the places that should be looked for in order to find any specimen, any kind of insect for further investigation. Now here are some practical guidelines for evidence collection. Insects can be collected from a corpse or its surrounding in three groups, namely we can find maggots, we can find soil insects and we can find the other insects. For maggots, maggots have to be immersed and killed in very hot water, that is almost boiling water, and then they have to be transferred to a solution of acetic acid, that is 3 parts 70% alcohol and 1 part glacial acetic acid. So 3:1 ratio is required. Now why do we require this almost boiling water? There are two reasons for that. First is that death of maggot is instantaneous in the boiling water, so exact moment of the death can be known. Also, hot water kills the maggots in relaxed state in which they are fully stretched. Measurements of maggots then has to be taken. If maggots are immersed in preservatives to kill them, they will shrink and any measurements will be difficult to interpret. That is why we kill them by putting them in boiling water and not by using preservatives. Any puparia, either empty or with the pupa inside, should be preserved in a specimen tube. All the containers carrying live specimen must be perforated for gaseous exchange so that the live organism get the proper oxygen and they can still breathe. Collect specimen from everywhere on the corpse. Try to collect specimen of every type, shape and size. Sample size will vary depending upon the number of larvae that is found. From all the larvae, where fewer than 100 are available, to 1 to 10% of the larvae where thousands are available. Then if you talk about the soil insects, then the soil sample should be collected in specimen bags from which insects can later be extracted in the lab. Each soil sample should be as much as would fit in a pint bottle. Soil should not be compacted. Storage in ethanol ensures that a later DNA analysis for identification is still possible, so we need to store them in ethanol. This may be necessary if a morphological identification is not possible. So this was all about this video. I hope you understood how the insects can be collected, how they should be preserved. Please like this video, share it with your friends, comment down if you have any problem. Also subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you for watching.